This is Ed. I'm the owner of AtticFoil.com. The other day I was talking to a customer and he said, "Hey Ed, give me a short and sweet version of everything I need to know to install AtticFoil radiant barrier." So I crammed in everything he needs to know in a couple of minutes and he said, "Hey, you should make that a video." I said, "Okay, well, let me see what I can do." So here's basically what I told him. The first thing is don't overthink it. People tend to think it's a lot more complicated than it really is. And really, all you're really trying to do, the big concept, is you're trying to get a piece of radiant barrier foil between the roof and the attic insulation. Normally, that roof gets hot, absorbs all the radiant heat from the sun, and then the roof re-radiates that heat across the attic space, and it heats up the insulation. This is heat transfer by non-contact. The whole concept of a radiant barrier is you want to get that piece of foil between the roof and the insulation. It's breaking that path and reflecting that heat back. Ultimately, what we're trying to do is keep the insulation cooler. The next thing you're going to do is staple it up. It doesn't matter whether it's straight or crooked or smooth or wrinkled. It really doesn't matter. It's going to work fine. It doesn't have to be pretty to be effective. You're going to use a 1/4 inch or 5/16 staples. Normally, you're going to run the radiant barrier foil horizontally across the rafters. The 48-inch product is kind of the standard product for most typical attics. If you've got a truss attic, you may want to consider running vertically or up and down and using the 26-inch wide product. Finally, you want to cover as much as possible. Radiant barrier has a cumulative effect. Just like if you were to put a tree over half of your house, it would help more than none of your house. Radiant barrier is the same concept. Some people will say, "Oh, if you don't get 80 or 90%, it's not going to be effective." It's effective no matter how much you get up. It's just a cumulative effect. The more you get, the better. And, you know, you're not going to get every little crack and corner with the radiant barrier, so don't spend a ton of time trying to get every single corner. Finally, allow for attic ventilation. Attic ventilation is real simple. Air comes in the bottom of the attic, it flows through the attic, and it should go out the top of the attic. You're going to have soffit vents in the bottom and some type of vents on top. It can be ridge vents, wind turbines, static vents, or possible fans. But really, you want to give that path a free path to go through. You want the air to flow through the attic as though the foil's not even there. You're going to leave gaps at the top and the bottom so that air can come into the attic. It can choose to go either between the foil and the roof or into the attic. And at the top, it's going to have a path to go out of the attic. That can be through ridge vent, through the wind turbines. Basically, if there's a hole in the roof, you want to have a corresponding hole in the foil. And you don't have to have ridge vent for radiant barrier to work. That air, that hot air, will find whatever hole is in the top of the attic. And it's really that simple. So basically, you're going to staple it up. You're going to get a piece of foil between the roof and the insulation. You're going to cover as much as possible. And you're going to allow for attic ventilation. That's the short and sweet version of everything you need to know to install AtticFoil radiant barrier. For more information, visit AtticFoil.com.